Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, reverentially referred to as Mahatma Gandhi, was born on October 2, 1869, in Porbandar, Kathiawar, India, during the time India was still part of the British Empire. Mohandas' father, Karamchand Uttamchand Gandhi, was married three times before marrying his mother. His first two wives died after giving birth to a daughter each, while the third wife was childless. After obtaining permission from his third wife, Karamchand married Putli Bai, a deeply religious woman who went on to give him four children: Laxmidas, son; Raliadbeh, daughter; Kasandas, son; and Mohandas, son. Although Karamchand had only basic education, he proved to be a capable chief minister in Porbandar. In 1878, Mohandas' father left Porbandar for Rajkot, a much smaller state. There he became a counselor to the ruler and in 1876 became the chief minister of the state. At age 9, Mohandas' family moved to Rajkot. When he was 11, he joined Rajkot High School. Young Mohandas was an average student who won some prizes in school. However, he was shy and tongue-tied. He had zero tolerance in sports and was always found in the company of books and school lessons. At age 13, Mohandas was married to 14-year-old Kastobai Mokanji Kapandia in an arranged marriage. In the years that followed, the teenager was overtaken by the vanities of youthful exuberance. He was not any different from boys his age. He smoked, ate meat, and stole loose change from household servants. However, young Gandhi was forced into maturity by the tragedy that hit him. In late 1885, Gandhi's father died. Gandhi was 16 years of age at the time, and his wife just put to birth. Unfortunately, the baby died too. The two deaths shattered him, but he would go on to have four surviving children, all boys, namely Harilal, 1888, Manilal, 1892, Ramdas, 1897, and Devdas, 1900. In November 1887, Gandhi graduated from high school at age 18. The following year, he enrolled at Samaldas College in Bhavnagar State, but dropped out later on that year. Gandhi's first ambition was to be a doctor, but Mavji Dev Joshigi, a Brahmin priest and family friend, advised him to study law in London. At that time, his wife had just put to bed his first surviving son, Harilal, and his mother was not comfortable to let him leave his wife and family and going so far from home. His uncle was against it. His elder brother, Laxmidas, who was already a lawyer, was his only ally and promised to support his studies. Gandhi had to swear before his mother that he would abstain from meat, alcohol, and women before she gave him her blessing to travel. In 1888, Mohandas sailed for London to study law. There he joined the Inner Temple, intending to become a barrister, and the London Vegetarian Society to help him uphold his vow to his mother. On returning to India in 1891, Mohandas learned of his mother's death a few weeks earlier. Gandhi would struggle to find his footing as a lawyer in Bombay, India. In his first case, Gandhi was so nervous that he blanked when the time came to cross-examine a witness. He refunded his clients for his legal fees and fled. By a stroke of luck, Gandhi received a one-year contract to perform legal services in South Africa. He was offered a total salary of £105, $17,200, plus travel expense for his services, and he accepted. In April 1893, he set sails for Durban, South Africa. Upon arriving in South Africa, Gandhi was immediately greeted by the racial segregation and discrimination faced by Indian immigrants at the hands of white British and Boer authorities. First, Gandhi was asked to remove his turban in his first court appearance in Durban. The young legal practitioner refused and left the court instead. Again, Gandhi was not allowed to sit with European passengers in the stagecoach. He was asked to sit on the floor near the driver, then beaten when he refused. In another incident on June 1893, Gandhi was thrown out of a train station in Pietermaritzburg en route Pretoria when he refused to move to the back because his presence made a white man uncomfortable in the first-class railway compartment of the train. That was the last stroke that broke the camel's back. Forthwith, Gandhi vowed to fight the disease of color prejudice. In 1894, he formed the Natal Indian Congress, and a civil rights activist was born. At the end of his year-long contract, Gandhi was about returning to India when he learned of a bill before the Natal Legislative Assembly that would deny Indians the right to vote. His fellow immigrants convinced him to stay and lead the protest against the legislation. Although the law was finally passed, Gandhi drew international attention to the prejudice. Gandhi returned to South Africa with his family after a short trip to India in late 1896 and early 1897. Upon his return, he set up a flourishing legal practice. During the Boer War, he instituted an all-Indian ambulance corps, a 1,100 volunteers to bolster the British cause. In 1906, in response to the South African Transvaal government's new limitations on Indian citizenship, including the refusal to recognize Hindu marriages, Gandhi initiated his first widespread civil disobedience movement, which he dubbed Satyagraha, Truth and Firmness. This led to his imprisonment together with hundreds of Indians. In 1913, the South African government, under pressure, accepted a compromise negotiated by Gandhi and General Jan Christian Smuts that included the recognition of Hindu marriages and the abolition of an Indian poll tax. In 1914, the activist decided he had had his fair share of South African action and decided to head home with his family. In 1915, Gandhi established an ashram that was open to all cases in Ahmedabad, India. He also started wearing a simple shawl and a loincloth to symbolize his identification with the poor. Gandhi lived an austere life, dedicated to prayer, fasting, and meditation. He became known as the Mahatma, meaning the great soul. In 1919, when the newly enacted Rowlatt Act authorized British authorities to imprison people suspected of being subverted without trial, Gandhi called for a campaign of peaceful protest and strikes in Satyagraha. Instead, violence broke out, which culminated in the Amritsar massacre on April 13, 1919. Machine guns were fired into a crowd of unarmed demonstrators by troops commanded by British Brigadier General Reginald Deer and killed nearly 400 men. Unable to bear the cruelty committed by the British government, Gandhi returned the medal he had earned in South Africa for his military service and opposed British compulsory Indian military draft to serve in World War I. Gandhi became a leading figure in the Indian Home Rule movement. He urged government officials to stop working for the crown, students to stop attending government schools, soldiers to leave their post, and citizens to stop paying taxes and buying British goods, called for mass boycotts. Instead of buying British-made clothing, Gandhi began using a portable spinning wheel to produce his cloth. The spinning wheel quickly became a sign of self-reliance and Indian unity. Gandhi became the leader of the Indian National Congress and advocated a non-violence and non-cooperation policy for achieving home rule. In 1922, Gandhi pleaded guilty to 3 counts of sedition after British authority arrested him and was sentenced to 6 years in prison. He was released after appendicitis surgery in February 1924. In his absence, ties between India's Hindus and Muslims devolved, resulting into murder. Gandhi launched a 3-week fast to call for reconciliation in 1924. In 1930, the activist returned to active politics to protest the Salt Acts of Britain, which not only prohibited Indians from collecting or selling salt, but also imposed a hefty tax. He led a new Satyagraha campaign, the Salt March, on March 12, 1930, which involved a 390-kilometer or 240-mile march to the coastal town Dandi, close to the Arabian Sea, where he would gather salt in symbolic defiance of the monopoly government. About 60,000 Indians, including Gandhi, who were incarcerated in May 1930, were jailed for violating the Salt Acts. Still, the protest against the Salt Act upraised Gandhi into an excellent icon around the world. In 1930, he was named Time magazine's Man of the Year. He was released in January 1931. 2 months later, he settled with Lord Irwin to conclude the Salt Satyagraha in exchange for the freedom of political prisoners. In August 1931, Gandhi attended the London Roundtable Conference on Indian Constitutional Reform as the sole representative of the National Congress of India. Nevertheless, the meeting proved fruitless. Gandhi returned to India in January 1932 and was imprisoned during a crackdown by Lord Willingdon, India's new viceroy. He started a six-day fast to protest against British decision to segregate the untouchables. He was released in 1934 and immediately quit the Indian National Congress. The reins of leadership shifted to his protege, Jawaharlal Nehru. Again, he paused his political movement to focus on education, poverty, and the problems that afflict the rural areas of India. As Great Britain became engulfed in World War II in 1942, Gandhi launched the Quit India movement to end British rule in India. The British captured Gandhi, his wife, and other Indian National Congress members in August 1942 and imprisoned them in present-day Pune at the Aga Khan Palace. Gandhi was released after a 19-month detention in 1944 with his health failing after the Labour Party defeated the Conservatives of Churchill in the 1945 British general election. It began negotiation with the Indian National Congress and Muslim League of Muhammad Ali Jinnah for Indian independence. Gandhi was released after a 19-month detention in 1944 with his health failing. After the Labour Party defeated the Conservatives of Churchill in the 1945 British general election, it began negotiation with the Indian National Congress and the Muslim League of Muhammad Ali Jinnah for Indian independence. The negotiation gave birth to two independent states along religious lines, primarily Hindu India and predominantly Muslim Pakistan. Much to Gandhi's disappointment, which had hoped for a unified India. On August 15, 1947, conflict raged between Hindus and Muslims. In an effort for reconciliation, Gandhi visited riot-torn countries and fasted. However, some Hindus increasingly perceived Gandhi as a traitor for expressing sympathy with Muslims. On January 30, 1948, the Hindu extremist Nathuram Godse, who was upset at Gandhi's tolerance of Muslims, shot and killed the 78-year-old activist during a late afternoon prayer meeting at the Bila House in New Delhi. In November 1949, Godse and a co-conspirator were executed by hanging, while other conspirators were sentenced to life imprisonment. Even after his assassination, Gandhi's commitment to non-violence and his belief in simple living has become a beacon of hope for beleaguered and downgraded people throughout the world. His life was an inspiration to future human rights activists around the globe, including civil rights leader Martin Luther King Jr. and Nelson Mandela. Thank you very much for watching our videos. We'd like to give you another exciting video for you to enjoy next. But before then, our team will be thrilled if you can like this video and share it with your friends on social media. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss other interesting videos like this. Look at your screen now to see two other videos we handpicked for you to enjoy next. We love you.